closing at a record high, 30.39.
The S&P 500 just hit a new all-time high.
Retail blows past expectations. Tech's leading today. Yields are falling.
We've got S&P record high.
It's no secret that right now the stock market is smashing through all-time highs in nearly every single sector. In 2020, we had one of the quickest and sharpest market crashes that we'd ever seen, with the S&P 500 falling 31% in just 1 month. But since then, to the surprise of most investors, instead of the market taking years and years to recover, in a matter of months, we were back to previous price levels. Now, we can look at a bunch of different indicators like the Warren Buffett indicator, which will tell us that the market right now is 89% above historical averages. Or we can also look at the Shiller PE ratio, which currently sits at 38, meaning that investors are willing to pay realistically more than double for the S&P 500 as to what they would normally pay for it historically. And no matter what other indicator we look at, they're all going to tell us the same thing, in that the market is absolutely, unequivocally overvalued. But the question we have to ask ourselves as passive investors then is, if the market is so expensive and overvalued right now, should we continue to invest into index funds and ETFs? And the short answer is yes. But in this video, I want to investigate and showcase why buying these expensive stocks may be exactly what we should be doing throughout 2021 and beyond. We'll start with a passive investing strategy known as dollar cost averaging. It's a strategy that aims to reduce the emotional aspect of investing and market timing. It's essentially an investment strategy in which an investor continues to contribute to their portfolio at set time intervals. By committing to a dollar cost averaging approach, investors avoid the risk that they will make counterproductive decisions out of greed or fear, such as buying more when prices are rising or panic selling when prices decline. Regardless, if the market is up or down, you continue to invest into the stock market. This strategy is well documented and time tested, with world-class investors such as Warren Buffett and Jack Bogle suggesting we do exactly this. Let's take a listen to how Warren Buffett would invest if he were a passive investor.
Index fund, I would just take a very broad index. I would take the S&P 500, as long as I wasn't putting all my money in at one time. If I were going to put money into a index fund in relatively equal amounts over a 20 or 30 year period, I would pick a fund. And I know Vanguard has very low costs. I'm sure there are a whole bunch of others that do. I just haven't looked at the field. But I would be very careful about the costs involved, because all they're doing for you is buying that index. I think that the people who buy those index funds on average will get better results than the people that buy funds that have higher costs attached to them, because it's just a matter of math. If you have a very high percentage of funds being institutionally managed, and a great many institutions charge a lot of money for doing it and others charge a little, they're going to get very similar gross results but different net results. And I recommend to all of you reading John Bogle's written a couple of books in the last 5 years, and I can't give you the titles, but they're very good books, and anybody investing in funds should read those books before investing, or if you've already invested, you still should read the books, and it's all you need to know really about fund investing. So I would pick a broad index, but I wouldn't toss a chunk in at any one time. I would do it over a period of time, because the very nature of index funds is that you are saying, I think America's business is going to do well over, or reasonably well over, a long period of time, but I don't know enough to pick the winners, and I don't know enough to pick the winning times. There's nothing wrong with that. I don't know enough to pick the winning times. Occasionally, I think I know enough to pick a winner, but not very often. And I certainly can't pick winners by going down through the whole list and saying this is a winner and this isn't and so on. So the important thing to do, if you have an overall feeling that business is a reasonable place to have your money over a long period of time, is to invest over a long period of time and not make any bet implicitly by putting a big chunk in at a given time.
But this still doesn't really answer the original question. Why should we invest thousands of hard-earned dollars into the stock market when we know for a fact that it's currently two or even three times overvalued right now? Why shouldn't we just wait for the market to cool off or have a slight correction? And that is definitely a legitimate question that I'm sure a lot of you have asked yourselves, and one that I myself have asked too. But instead of me answering this, I'm going to let Jack Bogle, the godfather of index investing, explain it.
So it shows you that when you act on the emotions of the marketplace, you're making a big mistake. You know, I stay and always have said, stay the course. Don't let these changes in the market, even the big one, that was the 50% decline. Don't let that change your mind. And never, never, never be in or out of the market. Always be in at a certain level. You know, you may want to be 50% in the stocks like I am. You may want to be 75% or 25%. That's probably a decent range. But never be out and think you can get back in, because your emotions will defeat you totally.
One of my favorite Jack Bogle lines is when somebody says, buy and hold is dead. Or when they ask you, is buy and hold dead? What do you say? You always say, depends on what you buy, right?
Well, buy and hold for a stock is one thing. Buy and hold the U.S. stock market is quite a different one. You know, what do we have going for us in the U.S. stock market? Leave aside how hard it is to pick the winners, how few people really ever heard of Amazon 25 years ago, to say nothing of Google, maybe a little more than that, maybe 30 years ago. So if you hold the stock market, you will, not to be corny, Bill, but you will grow with America. The correlation between the long-term growth of America's gross domestic product, so-called GDP, and the stock market is, you know, something like 95. But the annual correlation of those two things is probably 20. So, you know, you're making a good long-term bet, but short-term betting is just not a good way to go.
What we can summarize from this is that as passive investors, we should simply stay the course and continue investing into the total stock market. Don't try to outsmart the market or get emotional, because even though there will inevitably be some corrections or crashes, the market will always continue to go up. Just look at the S&P 500 over the past 20 years. Sure, there have been some dips and bumps here and there, but the market has always recovered and continued to go higher. Even if you invested right before the GFC or right before the COVID-19 crash, today you'd still be up on your investment. Furthermore, historical data does not support the idea that investing when the market is high is likely to produce lower future returns. In fact, according to JP Morgan, investing on days where the S&P 500 closed at a new all-time high can actually produce better returns than investing on a day where the market didn't set a new record. Just look at the following chart, which shows the average cumulative total returns over a 1, 3, and 5-year period if you had invested your money on a day where the S&P 500 reached an all-time high versus any other day. So as passive investors, we need to stay the course and continue investing into the total stock market. It doesn't matter if the market is overvalued or undervalued. It doesn't matter if the media is telling us that there might be an impending crash. We should just treat all of that as noise and continue investing. Anyways, that's all from me for this video. If you've made it this far, make sure you hit that like button so that the YouTube algorithm can share this out to more people. Until next time, guys, see ya.